It's the world.
I'm MP World. New Jimmy High Roller video. We've all been fooled. Why have we been fooled, Jimmy?
The triple-double stat line is synonymous with a great performance.
Get it!
When a player puts up a triple-double, the stat line tends to make more headlines than the actual game itself.
Right.
But with each and every NBA season, the once fleeting triple-double has become more and more common.
Right.
The stat line is almost casual at this point. No more rare.
All right, it's not casual, but you know what I mean.
Than a 30-point game. And because of this, the triple-double has lost its once legendary status. Players are now chasing the stat line, putting their box score above the actual success of their team, disregarding the win-loss column and focusing solely on the points, rebounds, and assists column. At least, that's what some fans think. The main perpetrator being Russell Westbrook.
He's definitely the main perpetrator.
Piling up wild stat lines often look more like a gimmick than anything else. But does that make the triple-double itself a gimmick? A charade of a stat line disguising its...
What was that about? I'm gonna let it go.
...itself as a great all-around game. Or is the triple-double still the gold standard for a great game of basketball? Well,
I think so.
There's only one way to find out.
Uh-oh. I'm down for any Lakers beef.
Today's video is brought to you by SeatGeek.
Let me skim a little bit forward past this. Adder. I'm down for anything that goes against the Lakers, bro. Not a Laker fan.
The first recorded triple-double in NBA history occurred on December 14th, 1950, over 70 years ago, and it was accomplished by a player named Andy Phillip, who racked up 17 points, 10 assists, and 10 rebounds. Now, I say this is the first recorded triple-double because prior to the 1950 season, the NBA just didn't keep track of rebounds and assists the majority of the time. It's like they just said, screw it. Who needs any of those arbitrary numbers anyways? Nowadays, the NBA could give you comprehensive play-by-play data on how often a player ties his damn shoes. Because numbers give us a great insight into the smaller nuances of the game. In the case of Andy Phillip, his numbers told us that he was a great player that could just about do it all on the court.
For sure.
Numbers don't lie. But in the wrong context, they do a really good job of skewing the truth. And over the last few seasons, the narrative around the triple-double stat line has been twisted and butchered so bad that most fans have been led to believe that the stat line is nothing more than a stat padding facade, that the triple-double has lost its value. I'm sure we've all heard this skepticism at some point. And your friendly neighborhood old head isn't completely
wrong.
Rush. The stat line is far more common now than it used to be. Kyle Lowry has more career triple-doubles than Scottie Pippen. Luka Doncic hasn't even played four full seasons in the NBA, and he already has far more triple-doubles than Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant.
I didn't know that.
Bryant. And if that isn't crazy enough, Elfrid Payton has more career triple-doubles than Kevin Garnett and Hakeem Olajuwon. And we can thank Russell Westbrook for the rise of the triple-double. The man can pile up a bloated stat line better than anyone else in NBA history. It's incredible. Back in 2017, Russ did the impossible by becoming the first player in over 50 years to average a triple-double for an entire season. Now, prior to that historic season, the NBA would usually float between 30 and 40 triple-doubles a season. That's the entire NBA combined. But after Russ's 2017 campaign, the league has seen a massive spike in triple-doubles. Oddly enough, Russ's impact on the triple-double falls right in line with Stephen Curry's impact on the three-pointer. In other words, Westbrook is to the triple-double what Stephen Curry is to the three-pointer.
Both game
changers. Triple-doubles and three-pointers are extremely different from one another. Anyone can jack up more threes every game, although most players probably shouldn't.
Oh my goodness!
But not every player can go out and just pile up double-digit assists and double-digit rebounds.
I have to say this just because of that clip. I watched a full Laker game the other night, bro. If I do not understand how anybody is a fan of that team, or how can you sit there and watch that shit, bro? Like, it is a shit show, bro. It is a shit show.
On a good scoring night. Or can they? On October 28th, 1979, a new record was set for the youngest player to achieve a triple-double in an NBA game. The kid was only 20 years and 75 days old, and his name was Irvin, but you probably know him by his nickname, Magic. And Magic's record stood for a long time, until 20 years later when Lamar Odom recorded a triple-double at just 20 years and 54 days old.
Damn.
Lamar's record would stand for 6 seasons until LeBron James broke it at the age of 20 years and 20 days. LeBron's record would eventually fall 11 years later when Lonzo Ball broke it at the age of 20
okay,
years
Zoe.
And 15 days old. But Lonzo's record would fall just 5 months later
Damn.
When Markelle Fultz became the first teenager to record a triple-double in the NBA. At this point, the record should stand for a very long time. I mean, how many teens can record a triple-double? Never mind, LaMelo Ball broke the record just a few seasons later at just 19 years and 140 days old. And since the NBA can't draft players straight out of high school anymore, I really doubted this record would fall anytime soon. I stand corrected.
What?
What was once a stat line...
Hey, I'm a Giddy fan, bro. I rocks with Giddy. I didn't know he broke that record.
...reserved for only the most well-rounded elite players, has become an achievable milestone for a teenager who just last year had a scouting report that looked like this. And as the age of the youngest triple-double getter continues to fall, the number of triple-doubles continues to rise. 8 of the top 16 career leaders in triple-doubles are currently in the NBA. So, is the triple-double really a dead stat line? A relic of the NBA that has lost its value over the years? The short answer is no. The triple-double is still an incredible stat line that, for the most part, still represents great overall winning basketball. But the long answer is a lot more complicated than that. Russell Westbrook has taken a lot of heat for the fall of the triple-double. His game is constantly overanalyzed and overcriticized. And I'm here to tell you, if you think Russ's triple-doubles are empty stats that don't contribute to winning basketball, you're wrong. Since Russ's game-changing 2016-2017 season, he has racked up 157 triple-doubles.
Fuck.
And in those 157 games, his team has a record of 111 and 46, a 71% winning percentage over a 6-season span. That's equivalent to nearly 60 wins over the course of a season, which means that when Russ gets a triple-double, his team is elevated to that of a near 60-win squad. And this team success doesn't just apply to one team. This is an effect that Russ has on every single team he has played on.
Now look, the crazy thing is when I first started watching this, I was going to say to myself that these triple-doubles don't really equate to wins, but now I've been proven wrong. That's why I shut the fuck up.
From the Thunder to the Rockets to the Wizards and now
wow.
the Lakers, Russell Westbrook's teams win more often when he gets a triple-double, at times the difference being staggering. In 2017, overall, the Thunder won just 57% of their games. In the games where Russell Westbrook achieved a triple-double, the Thunder's winning percentage jumped to 81%.
That's high as fuck.
Last season, the Wizards won just 46% of their games when Russell Westbrook played, triple-double or not. In the games where Russ did get a triple-double, the Wizards won 61% of their games. That's the difference between a 37-win team and a 50-win team. Overall, in the last 6 seasons, Russ's teams have won 57% of their games. When he gets a triple-double, that winning percentage jumps all the way up to 71%. Russ's triple-doubles are definitively a good thing for him and his team. And fans will often say, if Russ just kept his turnovers down, made better decisions, and took care of the ball, then his team would be in better positions, assuming that the bad that comes with the turnovers outweighs the good of the triple-doubles. And again, this isn't exactly true. Because over the last 6 seasons in games where Russ has less than 4 turnovers, his team's record is 62-45,
wow.
a winning percentage of just 58%, which is almost exactly the same as his team's overall record over that same time span. So believe it or not, Russ keeping his turnovers down to a minimum actually doesn't make much difference to his team's success. Sounds impossibly odd. But it's true. Meanwhile, the triple-double drives his team to vastly more success than without it. In the case of Russell Westbrook, a triple-double is far more valuable than a low turnover game. And it's not
what
even
about
close.
Threes, though?
But the Russell Westbrook triple-double rabbit hole goes even deeper. Since 2017, Russ has recorded 34 40-plus point games. And in those 34 games, his team went 19-15. A 56% winning percentage. Which, again, means that when Russ drops 40 points or more, his team's success virtually doesn't change at all. So that means that low turnover games and high scoring games are both far less valuable to Russ and his teams than the triple-double is. Not only is the triple-double not an empty stat line, the triple-double is quite literally the best thing Russell Westbrook can do for his team. In fact, generally speaking, the triple-double is one of the best things a player can achieve for his team across the league. These are the league leaders in triple-doubles since the 2016-2017 season. And across the board, the success of each player's teams jumps considerably whenever they get a triple-double. I think triple-doubles have gotten a bad rap in the same way that three-pointers have. If a player knocks down, let's say, 8 threes in a game, fans expect that player's team to win. But sometimes that's just not the case. Right. An individual player can do everything in his power to get a victory for his team, but other factors can prevent that from happening. And this applies with triple-doubles. People expect that a massive stat line in the form of a triple-double must equate to a win, or the numbers were empty, or the player was just padding his stats. But that's just not how the game works. Now, I know this is a difficult concept for some to understand, but a player can have a great game, and his team can still lose. I know, it's crazy, right? A triple-double doesn't automatically equate to winning every time, but it sure as hell gets your team in the winning column more often than not. Even in the case of Russell Westbrook. Over the last 5 seasons, there have been 534 triple-doubles recorded across the NBA.
How many are Russ's?
Out of those 534 games, the player with the triple-double won 375 of them. Now how's that for empty stats?
Hey, there we go. The more we know. Stop acting like the triple-double ain't that impressive no more, man. Every time somebody do some shit that's amazing, everybody forget how crazy it is, man. Them shits are still crazy, man. Until next time, it's...